Let's go over to our man, Mr.
Teddy Kekstadt, we got it.
It's a beautiful thing.
We got a lot going on in the market, I know. Get it to
as
you.
We do each and every Wednesday at 40 past the hour. You can reach Teddy every trading day, folks, at forex-trading-unlock.com. That's forex-trading-unlock.com. That website is your key to online forex trading.
Well,
Teddy Kekstadt, what's going on, brother?
How you guys doing? A little mixed bag of goods here with the currency markets. I think there's a lot of people watching the TV right now and not looking
there's
at
something
what the markets
going,
are.
What's going on? The
yeah, there's slightly something going on in the markets. Just seems to shake it off, man. I mean, it's a trip in itself.
They do. They do. But it also seems like there's just a little bit of a lack of direction, especially right now with the dollar. So it's just the dollar index, I think, is looking pretty heavy. As soon as it starts to kind of make a move, I mean, it's just been really knee-jerky the past few sessions. And I think we're starting to head into, I mean, we have holiday markets coming up next week in the U.S. to begin with.
Yeah.
And I think these hearings are starting to really weigh on the dollar as far as, you know, whether you're a bull or a bear, there's too much indecision going on right now. So I think you kind of have to look at some of your lesser major crosses for some swings. You know, I think the yen right now, you got to look for a breakout maybe to the upside.
Yeah, that yen, man, that 109.29 or 109.30, man, is a dangerous spot for me. Anyone trading gold in general, do you know what I mean? You know, we get up.
That's exactly where I'm looking at right now as far as an upside breakout, right in that area.
No, I'm with you, man, because, you know, the bottom line, folks, is that, you know, it's got up there a couple times, and, you know, it had every right to basically jump over it. You know, and that was like 2 weeks ago. We got to the 109.49. It just gave it up, man. So you're still dealing with this. Yeah, it's a 109.32, man.
Right.
We'll see what that baby.
I think the dollar also has, as far as the Asian currencies, the yen is something that it just has a good hold on right now. It's hard to really get that market to sell off, no matter what happens to the dollar index.
Yes. You know, the pound seems to be catching a pretty good bid. I mean, it's been at this 129.17 for a couple of days, but it seems to be pressuring the top of that range. You know, and if it can break, you know, topside, that thing could. Well, what do you think it could do?
Well, I think that the pound has a good shot at going up instead of a lower 130 handle, $1.30 handle for sure. I think just technically it looks like it's going to go there. Now, they have some debates on Friday coming up, and I guess the recent one from what I've read and looked at is that this Corbyn guy did pretty well for himself. But that doesn't necessarily mean that he's gaining any type of real momentum. It's just that he seems to be able to handle himself well. So I think that they're looking to see what happens on Friday's debates. But still, I'm bullish the pound overall.
Yeah. And the euro just hasn't moved, right?
I mean, it just can't seem to gain any strength. I mean, it looks like it wants to pop. And I think I'm right now a little bullish right now. I think right now I'm long. So
I'm glad you have. I mean, because if we got movement in the euro, that's when the dollar would get croaked. I mean, that's the reality, right? That, you know, the dollar is 60%.
So.
Yeah. Right.
Right. And it doesn't seem like the euro wants to do it. Like, it gets a little spike, a nice little rally, and then it just doesn't want to go. Now, I like I said, I am bullish, but I don't think that there's really much to the upside. I think it's just going to be a crawling little creeper of a rally, you know?
Yeah, so you get that. Well, you're probably looking at that 112, right? You're at 110 right now, the top of the range.
Yeah,
maybe. Yeah, right.
And I think it could take like a week and a half to get there, literally. And then that's probably where it'll run out of gas.
Yeah. Hey, Teddy, what happens, like, you know, as you just mentioned, we're coming up to Thanksgiving, then we're coming up to Christmas. Now, I can see the Christmas, that would affect everything because we have Christmas. Every different religion has different times at that time. What happens at the Thanksgiving deal? Does the dollar slow down and the other currencies, or is it just our dollar that slows down, meaning in trading-wise?
Oh, in trading-wise.
Yeah.
In trading-wise, I think you definitely what happens for the most part is you do start to get really thin markets because of all the people that take off.
Yes.
So at this time, you have nothing but really machines running completely, especially in the last 2 weeks.
I got it. Okay. And that's really good to know, right? Because that's where, whether you're a bull or a bear, you can get caught on the wrong side pretty quickly, right?
Right. Well, and you know what's kind of funny is, like, I remember the days on the trading floor, like, there was the people that had to show up for work during the holiday markets, you know, who worked for the firms and ran the desks and what have you, the skeleton crews. But as far as the real market makers, whether they were really good traders or bad traders, you know, for the most part, they did not come in during the holidays, and especially during those last 2 weeks.
Right.
Because they knew the market was thin. If the market, if something came in, it really pushed it in a vacuum move. And this is back then when it was a totally different kind of dichotomy, you know. So, but I think that right now you only have machines running at, during this time, because nobody, if you're a veteran trader, after a few years, you realize that if you're there on Christmas Eve trying to make money, it's not that you're an Ebenezer Scrooge, you're a moron.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
It's about enjoying a few things.
Yeah. Totally. Trading should not be there.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. No, for sure. And we all look forward to it too. I mean, that's the other side of it, right? It's like, okay, you know, Tommy and I talk about it. Where's that? Like, there's one streak that we get days off of the year, and then all of a sudden we don't get a day off again for a long period of time.
Well, I guess since we're talking about it, I just happen to be looking. I mean, this is the NYSE holidays, and the front end of the year is more loaded than not. So you got New Year's, but then you got Martin Luther King Day, January 21st, Washington's birthday, President's Day, February 18th. You got Good Friday, Memorial Day. And then you're basically refined to July 4th, Labor Day, Thanksgiving, and Christmas.
So we're just coming up to it now, which is pretty cool.
And Christmas and New Year's both falling, and that's why I was pulling this up
in
originally,
the middle of the
on
week.
A Wednesday. So you're going to have a Tuesday half day, I believe. And this is where I just looked up NYC holidays for anybody looking for this themselves. So we're looking at 2019, and if you get down to the asterisks, right, we got two of them. In terms of, you're going to get a half day on Friday for the Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Okay, now that's when we'll be closed. But in terms of Christmas, you're going to get the 25th, and you're going to be closed on a half day on Tuesday, the 24th.
Okay.
But then I believe as well, when you back it up, that maybe, I was looking for New Year's Eve. No New Year's Eve, love?
Yeah, they make us work then.
New Year's Eve, love.
Right, no, they make us work.
Right.
Pretty wild.
There'll be some champagne popping in the Wall Street offices on New Year's Eve till 4 p.m.
Oh, yeah. No doubt.
There's nothing else to do those days.
I agree. That's why I was actually surprised, yeah.
What about the Swiss franc, man? Where is that heading right now?
The Swiss franc right now, the U.S. dollar Swiss is rallying right now, so the Swiss itself is under pressure. And I think that right now you have this little kind of boost in the dollar index. It's trying to fight for a little bit of a rally. And I think that's where you're going to see the most of the momentum to the upside is the Swiss. But then also once it turns, that's where you also see the biggest breaks. Like, it's kind of crazy. Like, the euro has been in an uptrend now for a few sessions. And even today, it slammed lower and then came back up near its where it opened up. And the Swiss is the one that has the action. How is that possible? It doesn't make any sense.
Okay.
You know,
That's intriguing.
Now, there is a big number coming out on, is it Thursday or Friday? Friday is GDP coming out.
Okay.
So that's a big number to watch.
Unreal. Listen, folks, you can reach Teddy every trading day at forex-trading-unlocked.com. Teddy, you have a great week, a safe week, and, of course, we look forward to speaking to you next Wednesday. Yeah, it's going to be right before Thanksgiving.
That's right. We'll still be talking.
I like it, man.
Thanks, Teddy.
Okay, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one.
Thank you.
Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I come right back.